Golden gate cloning is a cloning technique that exploits unique features of type IIS restriction enzymes. Type IIS restriction enzymes are characterized by cleaving outside of their recognition sequence. The sequence present at the cleavage site is determined based only on its location relative to the recognition sequence. BSA1 is a type IIS restriction enzyme commonly used in golden gate cloning. Since cleavage occurs at a set distance from the recognition sequence for each type IIS restriction enzyme, the composition of the overhang can vary from cleavage site to cleavage site. In the case of a type IIS enzyme with a 4 base pair overhang, there are 256 possible overhangs associated with a single recognition site. Therefore, mere cleavage by a particular type IIS enzyme does not guarantee compatible ends. The only way to guarantee compatible ends is to design them into your cloning strategy. Golden gate cloning was first described by Engler et al. In 2008. It is described as a one-pot, one-step, precision cloning method, for as you will see, restriction enzyme and ligase are co-incubated. In developing and describing their system, the authors chose to reuse some of the terms used for gateway cloning. These are entry vector, entry clone, destination vector, and expression clone. Functionally, these elements have the same purpose. Both gateway and golden gate are designed for the modular assembly of genetic material into a complex clone for protein or gene expression. The entry vector is used to capture a gene fragment of interest to create an entry clone. In most cases, you will need to build several entry clones. These will be your building blocks for your final expression clone constructs. In order to create your final expression clone, a subset of your various entry clones will be used to provide insert material. With proper design, golden gate cloning can assemble as many as 35 fragments in this seamless, scarless fashion. Let's talk about the pros first. Golden gate cloning is fast. In addition, golden gate cloning is a seamless cloning technique. And finally, when everything is working properly, you will have no need to screen through background colonies. To start, you need to plan carefully. As the fragments you plan to clone become progressively longer, the odds of an extraneous restriction site interrupting your desired clone increase. A great deal of design and prep time is required to establish a new golden gate cloning system in your lab. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.